Today I'm in White Rock, BC, in a place called Centennial Park. And today I'm meeting up with this lady who has a very special pet. The one thing about exploring some of these little hidden caves and holes is you don't know exactly what could be living inside of them. So you have to be very careful, very cautious when you're doing it. It's actually the spider webs that make me nervous because I have a bit of an arachnophobia, but there's absolutely nothing in here. But you get these really nice pink flowers that grow just outside here and they bloom and they're extremely beautiful. And they make for some amazing photos. As a wildlife photographer, what might be icky and gross to you can be absolutely beautiful to someone else. Looks like there's a tent in here. What do you know? Yeah, so looks like someone has been sleeping in here. This would be a great place to crash. Nobody's around. It looks like it's been abandoned for quite a while. It's actually a very good tent. It's expensive. It's not like a $5 one that you'd find at like a Zeller's. Yeah, it's a very nice tent.
Okay, well, this is Loki. And we got her because me and my husband were thinking about getting snakes for about 2 years and had gotten everything ready and had found a breeder to go and pick out a baby snake. Loki, we got the call and she came from a busted and grow up that a couple of pot dealers had Loki, a corn snake and a eastern melt snake, three different species of snake in a large tank together, which any reptile keeper does not do. Loki was on deathbed, super anemic at 6'4". She was only 7 pounds. She went to Dr. Adrian Walton, who pretty much told her we could have her, but she would probably die. And that was August of last year. Since then, she's, you know, sprung right back. Her color has come back, and she's doubled in weight now, and gained a couple of extra inches on her. And very happy, healthy snake who, you know, just needs somebody to take care of her.
This is Apophis. He is our anatheristic boa constrictor. He's a boa constrictor imperator. He is 1 year old. He doesn't display red pigment, as you can see by the fact that he's gray with red with blue spots instead of the standard red red spots on a brownish body.
I'm Jason Kenzie, and this is Life Through My Lens.
Not funny.